Welcome to season 2, episode 3 of Keys Corner. I appreciate you posting up with your boy. As you see, we got a whole different vibe going on today. Why? Because it's the gentleman's episode today. I'll tell you what I mean right after we get into the kick of the day. Keep it real simple today. Just pulled out the white on white Air Forces. Some of y'all, especially my New York folks, might know these referred to as Uptowns. But these white on white Air Forces blew up when Nelly made the song about it. Everybody knows the song, Air Force Ones. But I'm telling you, there is no cleaner shoe that goes with everything in your closet. Even this suit that I got on. Could probably pull off some Air Force Ones. Always keep a crispy pair of Air Force Ones in your closet. If you ever scrambling to find a shoe to go with that certain outfit, I promise you, a crispy white on white is all you need. To all my sneakerhead fans out there, don't worry. I hope this ain't a letdown, but I promise you, in the next few weeks, we dropping nothing but straight retro heat. Now, we gonna kick it back out to Keith. What's good, everybody? Welcome back to Keith's Corner, the Gentleman Edition. On this Gentleman's Edition of Keith's Corner, we gonna be giving y'all some drip tips. Now, for those of y'all that don't know, I'm a huge cologne fan. I'm a cologne connoisseur. And one of my goals is to come out with my own cologne. It's something that I've actually been working on for a few years now. I kind of got sidetracked with it for a while, but I definitely plan on picking it back up, especially because as of lately, I've been seeing a lot of other like cologne videos, people posting their top 5 colognes. And to be honest, I'm always seeing the same 5 in people's top 5 colognes. And they're either 1, not that great at smelling colognes, or 2, they're just really, really high-end expensive colognes that normal people would not be able to afford or buy. So I'm gonna give y'all my top 5 sleeper colognes. So please pull up a chair and enjoy some cheap wine and some cheap colognes with your boy. The first cheap cologne that the first cologne on their list that I'm gonna break down their list for them. The first cologne on their list is Sauvage by Dior. To be honest, Sauvage by Dior is not too bad of a smelling cologne. It's really not too expensive. And in all honesty, I think the only reason why it blew up was because, for one, it's Sauvage. Everybody got caught up in the craze of calling themselves a savage. So, you know, men wanted to go out and wear Sauvage. And so I think that's one of the things that kind of blew it up. Don't get me wrong, like I said, it's a good cologne, smells okay, but I just don't think it deserves to be in the top 5. The other cologne that is in a lot of people's top 5 is the Eros by Versace. Again, to be honest, I think the only reason why a lot of people wear this one is because of the name Versace attached to it. I've got some Versace colognes, and to be honest, they're not even in the Versace colognes that I have. They're not even in the top 10 scents amongst my collection, and I have a pretty big collection of colognes. The next one that I have is 1 Million by Paco Rabanne. To be honest, I really don't even think this is all that great of a smelling cologne. It's in a lot of top 5s. It's okay. It's a very dark tony cologne. I don't think it's all that great of a scent. I think it's highly overrated and does not deserve to be in the top 5s that it is. And another one that to me just does not smell good at all is Spice Balm. To me, Spice Balm smells like a taxi cab driver. I just don't think it deserves to even be in the top 20. It just baffles my mind to see people listing that one. And the next cologne after that is Creed Aventus. Great smelling cologne. Absolutely should be in people's top 5. However, for this cologne, you're gonna pay a minimum of $200 to $300 minimum, and that's for a smaller size bottle of this cologne. Don't nobody need to spend that much money on a cologne. So with that being said, I'm gonna give y'all my top 5 sleeper colognes. The thing about these is these are good scents to have that won't break the bank. First things first, I'm gonna start off with, if y'all don't know, a gentleman should not have just one scent for the entire day. There's different scents for different times of day. And there's different scents that should go for different occasions. There's even a gentleman should smell good 24/7. So there's a reason why that colognes even make sports scents, because even during endurance activities and gym and stuff like that, you should always smell good. So that's why there's even sports scents like that. So one good scent that is good, especially if you work outdoors, I promise you, if you work outdoors and you smell, you work in the dirt, maybe you work in the oil field or whatever, if you want to smell good, Izumiaki. Izumiaki is a good crisp cologne. It just smells fresh. It smells like fresh out of the shower. It's a good clean scent. And you could be outside wearing it. You could be outside working and wearing this, and I promise you, nobody's even gonna say that you stink, because it's just such a good clean scent, and it overtakes your body. It really sticks good to you. That's a good scent to have right there. Izumiaki. The next one I want to bring up is Lacoste. Now, everybody knows the brand Lacoste. They have a bunch of different colors of these ones that are made to look like the polo shirts that they have. They have red, blue, black, yellow, green, white, the L1212. That's the only one that you need to concern yourself with when it comes to these. This one right here is an evening scent. And every time I wear this one, this is the one that I always get compliments on, L1212. This one right here just has a good masculine scent. It overtakes you. I remember one time we went out to the club, and it was a real strong smoky scent in there. And still, the only thing that I was getting was just straight compliments off of this cologne right here. And it's a good, on the cheaper end, you can get a good bottle for about $35, $45. Not too bad. Nothing like the Creed Aventus. So this is a great scent that's real strong. You don't need to spray a lot for it to overtake your body and be to smell good. So I definitely recommend getting the Lacoste 1212. The second one I want to talk about, Dolce & Gabbana, light blue. So nice, I bought it twice. Kinda, not really. This is a really, really great scent. It's a really popular scent. The Dolce & Gabbana light blue, it's a really, really popular scent that they've had a bunch of spin-offs. They've had the summer scent, they've had the Italian zest, the citrus. They've had a lot of different spin-offs of these. To be honest, I really don't concern myself with any of those. The light blue, the normal one, this is the original. This is the only one I really concern myself with. And actually, the Intenso. This is the exact same one. It's just a little bit stronger. It's got more perfume than what it does water, so it's less watered down. This one is a lot stronger. I'm somebody that I like to smell it on myself, so I do prefer the Intense. But if you want a lighter scent, you don't want it to be so overbearing, then just go with the normal. But for me, I'm definitely going to take the Intense. A few of these sprays will last you. I'm telling you, this will last you on your shirt for about a week. And then one of my personal favorite designers is Carolina Herrera. Not just because I share a last name with her, but because she has some amazing scents. And even more so, the 212. And this is not going to be on my top five because this is super hard to find. It's super hard to find, and it's a little bit more expensive than some of the others. So I think because it's so exclusive, it is a special edition. But if you can find the 212 Surf, that's this one right here. This is going to be my honorable mention right here. The 212 Surf by Carolina Herrera. I'm telling you, this one is such a good scent. And it's a good summertime scent. Summer is coming. If you're going on a cruise or you're going to a beach, this is all you need right here. This is a good, good relaxing scent. I love the smell of this one. I only break this one out for extreme special occasions. And the 212 NYC Men. This one right here, I get lots of compliments with this one right here. It's very musky. I love this one. It's good. And this was something that a few sprays, and again, it'll also stay on you. That's what I love about these colognes right here, because for the price, you're getting something that's gonna last on you. It's gonna smell, it's gonna last you all day. Because if you don't know, a lot of colognes, they have shelf life that on your body, that some will only work for 2, 4, 6, about the max that you'll get from any cologne is about 8 hours. But I remember I've left some shirts out before where I've sprayed these colognes, and I'll find those shirts like maybe a week later and it's still smelling super strong. So with these ones right here, you're definitely getting more bang for your buck on these ones. The NYC 212 Men, this is definitely a cologne that you want to pick up. It's an evening scent. So if you're really trying to make an impression, this is definitely the way to go right here. Now I could give y'all some more drip tips on how to actually properly apply cologne, but don't get me started. That's a whole other segment for another day. At this time, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna give y'all another tip for before you go out and you wanna maximize your presence. So I'm gonna go ahead and bid a toast to y'all and kick y'all out to Keith's Crafts. Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to this segment of Keith's Crafts. Now, if you don't know, I'm in my man cave bathroom right now. What could we be doing in here? Now, I'm somebody who, when I'm not wearing my grill, I care about my smile. I don't really smile often, but when I do, I like to know that my smile is on point. Like, I don't want anybody saying, oh, his teeth are yellow or whatever like that, you know, especially me being somebody who's always up in front of a crowd, teaching, doing something, or behind the camera, or in front of the camera, I should say, doing stuff like that. I don't ever want to worry about my smile. Like most people, it's a confidence thing. I'm somebody who likes to look, feel, smell, you know, total confidence, right? Because when your confidence is up, everything about you is up. So now most people, you know, like most people, they do like to take care of their smiles. However, some people like to spend their time with, you know, whitening strips, whitening mouthwash, or even whitening toothpaste with charcoal. Or I even have a toothbrush that's infused with charcoal. The bristles are infused with charcoal. Now charcoal has been something that you can do often. It's not really bad for you. It's something that you can do pretty often, but they don't recommend you doing it every day. But all the other whitening stuff, that stuff is killer for your enamel. So all that stuff is not recommended by dentists that you do any of that stuff every day. So one of the things that I like to do, that I used to do back in the day, I kind of got away from doing it. I haven't done it in a while, but is a mixture of coconut oil and turmeric, however you fucking say it. Anyway, a mixture of this two, you could do this every day. Not gonna lie, it doesn't taste all that good. And you do have to take into some other considerations when you're brushing with this. Some of the things, some people say you can't spit it down the drain. One, it'll stain your sink. And two, that it can clog your sinks. But I don't think it's all that big of a deal. I think you can go ahead and put it down. But basically, you just want to take about, this is a half a teaspoon right here. Take some of that coconut oil. Just really pack it in there. It's a half a teaspoon, but shit, pack it in there. Who cares? It's probably kind of gross to be mixing this stuff here in the restroom, but hey, look, I'm clean as hell, so it ain't too bad. Go ahead and take some of that turmeric. Turmeric might be the spice of the year. Maybe it's just me, but I've been seeing turmeric all over the place. People coming out with stuff with turmeric and stuff like that. Very popular spice right now. And then you just want to mix that up. Give that a good mixture. It's gonna wind up looking like peanut butter. I promise you it don't taste like no peanut butter though. But go ahead and give that a good mix. So you're gonna want to get like a cheap toothbrush. I bought this set and I'm gonna use the toothbrush out of this set here. Got it right here. You're going to want to use that toothbrush because I don't think it'll stain your sink or anything like that. Some say it'll even stain your skin when you're using it, but I've never really had that issue. But it will stain your bristles, that's for sure. So you might want to get a cheap toothbrush just to do this little ingenious hack with. So if you need to whiten your teeth in a hurry, go ahead and do that. And you can see the mixture right there. It looks like some peanut butter.
Yeah, with like some peanut butter or honey mustard or something like that. So then you're gonna get your toothbrush and just slap it up on there. Now when you're brushing your teeth, you're gonna brush your teeth with this mixture. When you're brushing your teeth, you wanna try to get as evenly as possible, get it thoroughly in your mouth and onto every tooth. And then once you got it up in there, when you rinse out, you wanna try to like kind of gargle with it. Remember when you were a little kid and you would eat Jell-O and you would swirl it around in your mouth until the Jell-O turned to Kool-Aid? That's kind of what you wanna do with this right before you spit it out, because you wanna make sure that you get all that oil up out of your mouth. So, cheers to y'all. And voila, probably should have did a before and after, but I promise you, I noticed a difference. And I only really do this hack maybe not as often as what you can do. You can do this every day, but I probably only do it maybe like once a month. Well, I will be doing it probably more often now, because I mean, I noticed a difference. And I can even show y'all the sink. Like I said, I spilled some, and it doesn't even look like there's any stains or whatever. It doesn't look like it's too bad. Got some on my face. I don't feel like I stained at all. So I'm gonna go ahead and tell y'all, I think this is the best way to whiten your teeth quick, fast, in a hurry. And you could do it just as often. Stop wasting money on strips and special toothpaste that you shouldn't even be doing every day, and special mouthwash that you shouldn't be doing at all, because it kills the enamel. I would say go ahead and maximize your money by investing in these two things. So it's a great spice to have, good for chicken. I think El Pollo Loco uses this to season their chicken with, and coconut oil. If you're living a healthy lifestyle, coconut oil has many uses for you. So that's it. We're gonna send it right back out to Keith's Corner. I'm at your throat like Clara said. And you got strep, I'm too complex with that segment of Keys Crafts. Hope it brings y'all plenty shiny chiclets in y'all's future. No more suit, we had to turn the lights on, because now it's time to get barbaric in the club. What's good, everybody? We up in the clubhouse, and it's time to get barbaric with UFC 261, Usman versus Masvidal Part 2. I'm gonna give you all my fight predictions for this one. Really, really good card. Really excited for this one. Two female championship matches on the line. The first one being Shevchenko and Andrade. I'm gonna go with Andrade with the upset. The other female championship card, match on the card, it's between Zhang and Namajunas. And I'm actually going to take Nama with the upset on that one. So I'm going to say two out of the three championship matches will be upsets, because the third one is Usman and Masvidal. That's the big one that everybody wants to talk about. Everybody wants to see. And me personally, I think a lot of people are picking Masvidal to upset. I mean, he had a great showing on short notice against Usman last time. And he's a great fighter.
I just don't see him. I love Masvidal. I love Masvidal. I just don't see him beating Usman. Usman is on a whole other level and is on his way to being legendary status. And with him and Francis Ngannou representing their country, you know, being champions and everything, that's too much on the line for Usman. I don't see any way. You're not gonna get any quid out of Usman. I think he just has, it's more than a title that he's defending at this point. So I think there's a lot of pressure on him, but I think he's strong enough. He's a good enough fighter to where he'll live up to the pressure. So I'm definitely gonna take Usman. I'll say Masvidal, man, he's got a chin. He can take a hit, but you know what? I'm gonna go with the upset and say Usman puts him out in four. He's gonna test that chin. He won't tap Masvidal, but he's gonna put him down. I'm gonna say Usman KO in four. Could be wrong about that, but I don't think I'm gonna be wrong about who's gonna come out the victor on that one. So those are my predictions, and that's it for the clubhouse. Tune in next week. Kicks fans, I told y'all we're gonna bring out nothing but straight heat, and make sure you stay tuned. I got a lot in store coming up for these next few episodes. I'm Keith, and you just got corn.